second discipline of four that we'll be seeing today. Meanwhile, let's flash over to diving and take the plunge with Tim Brando.
They're awaiting her score. The leader right now, 9-6. And that put up by Kelly Pitson, who was the first competitor. Kim Zemeskal, remember, who won the all-around competition in the compulsories, had a bit of a problem in this event, finished with a 9-1. Gina Jackson was the third competitor. Shannon Miller, another local product from Edmond, Oklahoma, will start her routine in just a moment. There is a look at Shannon and the score for Gina Jackson, 9.35. I think the crowd here might have thought, Kathy, that she might have scored a little bit better than that.
Well, that's why we're trying to educate the people on the scoring system so they know there are some things that they just can't see that the judges do see.
Here's Shannon Miller. She has been a local favorite all week long.
She trains right here at Dynamo with Steve Nuno. She had the second highest score on this event in the all-around. It's a nice handstand pirouette to reverse hacked. Again, that release move should have been a little bit higher above the bar. She does a second release move, though, a ginger, which is a flyaway with a half twist. It's really important to start seeing those two release moves in one routine. Giant swing, half in, half out. Beautiful dismount. That is one of the most difficult dismounts being done on any event. It's a full twist and two somersaults. And off the women's uneven parallel bars, that is a very difficult thing to do.
And she stands to score very high. That's her teammate, Gina Jackson, who a moment ago put a 9.35 up. Take another look at this release.
Here's her second release move. It's a ginger. Shannon sometimes gets a little sloppy with her form. Her knees bend, her legs come apart. But the judges are going to be impressed with this. This is amazing. There's a half and a half. It's a full twist with a double somersault. Excellent.
So now she waits. Shannon Miller, 9-6, the score to beat. That put up by Kelly Pitson. And so far, this competition very much the same way it was. And a 9-7 for Shannon Miller to move her into first place. Listen to the crowd.
When the last thing the judge sees is that dismount, that really helps with the score.
Moves her into first place. What I started to say was this competition shaping up very much the way the men's did. Four winners in six events. We are in our second event and are going to have our second different winner.
Amanda has beautiful work on the uneven bars. It was a handstand pirouette to a Jaeger front. She was having trouble with that in warm-ups, but she really got it here. She has really the best form in the competition on the uneven bars. Up, legs came apart right as I said it. Double tuck flyaway. Only a couple of form deductions in there, but she had a release move. She had handstand pirouetting moves.
Good job.
She didn't have a dismount as difficult as the one we just saw Shannon do.
All I can say is I hope Bella never gets angry when he grabs those little kids by the head.
Now here's her Jaeger front. Decent height, just enough to keep the value at a D, though.
Will it be enough, however? Look at her dismount once more.
This is a nice, clean, double-tuck dismount. Now, you see right there was the deduction, the legs coming apart in the pirouette, but the tuck was beautiful.
9-7 is the score to beat put up by the competitor just ahead of her, Shannon Miller. And now Amanda Urich waits. It's just remarkable, and again, we've been talking about the fact that this is the future. What you're looking at here are the people whose names you'll know come 1992 in Barcelona.
Exactly, and they're part of the evolution of the uneven bars right now. They're allowing the gymnast to put the bars so much farther out. The rails are smaller. It's going to give them so much more room to swing. We're going to be seeing release moves in a row, back to back, like we saw last night with the men on high bar.
Interesting in general, the fact that most of these girls are 13, 14 years old, changed so dramatically in the next two or three years of their lives. 9.675, not quite enough to move into first place. It will put her in second place. Amanda Urich and Jana Rudin finished 2-3 respectively. And as Jim said, Jana Rudin so far the only double medalist. We take you now to the balance beam. Third competitor on the beam is Amy Shear. She's looking up right at the moment at her teammate, Kim Zemeskal, who put up a 9-7 a moment ago. Shannon Miller, who won on the uneven bars, 9.475 to start the beam competition. But here's Amy Shear.
I had a feeling we were going to have a great balance beam competition. We've gotten off to a great start. Two back roll extensions, right to handstand, showing some originality. Amy can be very tough on this event. She's very tough mentally. Here's her most difficult pass of the routine. Two layout step outs. Okay, she fought for that landing. She was a little bit off on that second layout, but she pulled it off. That's her one of the requirements, a gymnastic series, two leaps directly connected. That's a back tuck kick out to a straddle down. Another difficult move. Showing her flexibility and also another requirement, a gymnast must have an element down on the beam. Preparing for the dismount. A little bit too long there on the end. Round up, double back dismount. Little hop on the landing and also a little sloppy in the air. She had that cowboy position that Bart spoke about yesterday.
Oh, yeah, we'll see if it's enough. Bella liked it. Got a lot to shoot for here, though, 9-7, and she smiles. Nice to see that.
Kim's routine is going to be really tough to beat, but this was a nice, solid routine. Great angle for this. Back handspring, two layout step outs. You can see she's directly over the beam, but her legs are a little bit bent, and on the second one, her body tilted just slightly off kilter.
And the dismount.
Now watch, you can see this position in the air that really is not completely desirable. You should keep the legs together.
So we'll see if Amy Shear did enough. There's a look at Amy, already a winner in the vault.
Definitely enough to be pleased about. Anytime you hit your beam routine, that's something to smile about.
Yeah, it really is. And again, as you mentioned earlier, she's all business when she's competing, but she's out here today and just having a good time. And 9-7 on the beam will move her into a tie with her teammate, Kim Zemeskal. So she is having better than just a good competition so far.
It's a good score. I have to be honest, I wasn't sure if they'd give her that. But she had some of the original moves, the back rolls to handstand. Beautiful plant there by Erica Stokes.
Erica Stokes coming off an excellent all-around competition. She finished second in that competition to Kim Zemeskal and made a big comeback on the second day.
Erica's one of the prettiest gymnasts here in terms of form and execution. Two back handsprings to a layout step out. Just straight on the beam. Another one of her requirements, a full turn on one leg. Gainer back handspring to a seesaw. That's another requirement, but she does it quite well. It's a gymnastics acrobatic series in which you combine dance and an acrobatic element. Oh, and that is gorgeous. I love that move. It's a full twisting back handspring straddle down. It was invented by Elena Shishinova, former world champion, and it's just an Olympic champion. And actually, I think Erica Stokes does it better than she did.
You want to know what this is like? Just walk outside and get up on your backyard fence. Try doing a couple of flips.